is Nathalie Mamo from WWE AL AN with a very special episode dedicated to the holy month of Ramadan with a very special guest, WWE superstar Mustafa Ali. Welcome to WWE AL AN, Mustafa. Thank you so much for joining us, and Ramadan Kareem, as they say.
Ramadan Kareem, thank you.
Mustafa, we need to ask you, what does the holy month of Ramadan mean to Mustafa Ali?
It means a lot. It's a question I get asked every year about, you know, how does one perform in WWE while also doing the obligations that are expected during Ramadan. For those that don't know, during the month of Ramadan, Muslims across the world fast from sunrise to sunset. We abstain from food, water, and I have to do all of this while traveling the world, training and then performing. So it's a daunting task, but you know, I've been doing this for such a long time, almost 17 or 18 years now. So I've grown accustomed to it. And you know, the month itself is a time of inner reflection. You see what you have and others don't have. What I'm most fond about Ramadan is that it puts everything in perspective. Right before I break my fast, you know, as the sun sets and I feel the hunger in my stomach and I just can't wait to eat food, and I've been thinking about food all day, the idea of Ramadan and what it's supposed to instill in you is that at that moment when you feel that hunger, you're supposed to realize that there's millions of people across the world that feel that same hunger as you. The difference is, you know, you're about to eat. In a few minutes, there's going to be a hot plate with all this food and you're going to, you know, pig out, as they say. But there's millions of people that don't know when their next meal is coming. And the thought of that hunger, you not knowing when that hunger goes away, really puts a lot of things in perspective. So it's always, it's that month where you just really realize how blessed and lucky you are. So, you know, that's my takeaway from Ramadan, the hunger that I feel during the day. And right before I eat, I try to, you know, put myself in someone else's shoes, as they say, and realize someone out there doesn't know when they're going to get their next meal. So it just, you know, if you think you're having a bad day, that helps.
What is your favorite meal to break your fast on the first day of Ramadan?
So I'm Southeast Asian. My family's from Pakistan and India. So we've got quite the delicacies on deck. But my mother-in-law, she makes the best nahari. Like, nahari is this meat base. I don't know how to really describe it to those who don't know. But basically, it's like a really, really good meat dish that you eat with this thing called naan. It's a bread. Mm-hmm. It's my favorite thing. My favorite food in particular is this other dish called chicken makhani, but my mother-in-law makes the world-famous nahari. So, you know, during Ramadan, that's my go-to request.
You mentioned about how everyone asks you, how do you deal with the fasting while training and performing during the month of Ramadan? Can you tell us more about this?
Yeah. So I feel that the human body is amazing. You know, you put it through anything, and after a few days, a few weeks, it just grows accustomed to it. So, you know, I won't lie. You know, the first few days are a little rough, especially with the type of workouts that I do. I'm a very fast-paced, high cardio person. So my training reflects that, and doing that without water is kind of a dilemma sometimes. So what I do is I flip my schedule, basically. So as I stated earlier, we're allowed to eat, you know, and drink after sunset. So I typically will incorporate some sort of plyometric-based or cardio-based workout right before it's time to break fast. So I'm able to drink water, replenish, do prayer, and then eat. And then after I eat, I now have all this energy to build this food, and I'm able to go to the gym and then do weightlift training. So basically, instead of my normal routine, which is waking up in the morning and doing cardio, eating, and then doing weight training, I just flip my schedule now and I do it in the evening / night. So kind of simple, you know, just flip it.
Did any of your fellow superstars ever try fasting with you?
One person in particular did. His name is, you guys know him, Sheamus, you know, fella. We were doing an episode of his Celtic Warrior workout. We were preparing for that, and I had mentioned to him, I said, hey, can we do it at night because it's Ramadan and I'm fasting? So without me asking, he wanted to fast the whole day as well, so that when we did the workout together, he felt what I felt, you know, type of situation. So Sheamus had fasted the whole day, and then after the show that night, we went to a gym and worked out together. And he's like, I don't know how you did it. I was like, how do you do this for 30 days or whatever it is?
What's your favorite thing during the month of Ramadan?
As much as Ramadan's supposed to be a time of like reflection and peace and things slow down a bit, and you're supposed to, I almost feel like it's a little busy during Ramadan. You know, there's a lot of iftars, a lot of families getting together with, you know, with COVID this year. I don't know how that's going to play out, you know, with Eid. I don't know how that's going to play out, you know, as well as going for prayers, you know, Tarawih prayers at night, like, you know, all of that in our daily schedule is now not going to happen because of COVID-19. So I feel like this year will be, I don't want to use the word chaotic. I just want to, busy. Ramadan's busy for me personally. And then you add that on with travel and this, and now none of that's there again with this epidemic that we're going through, this pandemic we're going through. So maybe, yeah, this year in Ramadan, I'll actually be slow paced and I'll actually have time to reflect. But my favorite thing about Ramadan is that kind of like that busy chaos. You know, you see all of these people that you see them at the mosque, you see them at iftars, you see them at family get togethers. Eid is like, you know, again, for those that don't know, Eid is like the Muslim Christmas, basically. You know, we give gifts and we see each other. So yeah, I'm gonna miss that aspect of it. But I love the hectic schedule that comes with Ramadan. That's my favorite part, seeing these people that I might not normally see so much.
Mustafa Ali, what are your words to the WWE universe around the world, maybe celebrating Ramadan with you?
I wish you a happy, blessed, peaceful Ramadan. I hope you find clarity. I hope you take the time to really look at what you have and look at what others don't have, and then you walk away from it, you know, cleansed and refreshed and with a different perspective, an even better perspective than you've already had. And that's it. And my sincere love and appreciation to you all, and happy and blessed Ramadan.
Wish you and your family a very blessed month and a very happy Ramadan. We definitely
thank you very much.
Soon back in the Middle East when the whole pandemic is over. Thank you so much for being with us, and thank you for everyone watching WWE AL AN.